show yet? You got any work yet? Have you heard from anyone else? Anyone have this terrific job? Managing a big movie theater up in St. Petersburg. St. Petersburg, Florida. Not St. Petersburg, Russia. I'm not exactly managing, but I do have some duties. I'm meeting all kinds of interesting people. Life is great in Florida. Love, Carrie. Hey Ted, Teddy Ruxpin is my friend. Look, seriously, I'm in Maine. My job didn't turn out too well, so I decided to hibernate. Back to nature. I love it out here. Where anyone should be. Dear Ted, how's the boy? How's the boy? We're up in Pittsburgh and we're starting a rock band. Really amazing, really wonderful. Really now, wow, really amazing. Everything's really amazing. We hope you'll see us soon. Dear Ted, guess what? Harry Truman and I are traveling Aqua show. Not exactly Broadway, but it's got perks. Life is going swimmingly. Love, Chris and Michael Bell. Hey Ted, how's the boy? Guess what? I'm up in Delaware, so I started a new job. Things are going great and amazing, really wonderful. Really amazing and wonderful. So, everything's going great. Love, Brian. Signs of summer are ending from all around us. I refused to give up at first. Dad refused to give up at first. Wouldn't join it in September. We left Long Beach on for good. Occasionally I woke by the vending machines. All I expected to get this year was maybe some loose change. It was hopeless. Signs that summer was ending all around us.
How many guys are on the plane, do you think? Let's say between 12 and 16. Six of them.
Maybe he's asleep.
Good morning. Good morning, gentlemen. Colonel Alexander Delaforce.
It's about time.
You got enough fuel?
For what?
To fly to Israel.
You bet.
Thank you.
Juan, get out of there!
Okay, gang, let's go.
Well, you know how it is. I know how it is. Anyway, I was told I've been practicing, weirdness, craziness. I was charted, acting weird, messing with people's feelings, ruling out terrorism, visualizing justice, practicing religion without a license. We know how it is. Anyway, I spent 12 months in the asylum, but my psychiatrist got me out. You know how it is. Anyway, nobody remembered what happened. The media remember what happened. Many people guessed it was a fad that had been going around for a while. Anyway, John Paul and I reached a truce. I agreed not to breathe fire and damnation on him if we would just agree to do some things. Anyway, I said just leave him alone. Couldn't argue with that. I never used my creative talents for puppets again. I never used my creative talents for evil again. I never used a knife for anything other than preparing food. Mom went back to art school. She agreed not to collect antiques anymore. I know I promised my publisher duties were over. I couldn't argue with that. They figured out a guy that was just trying to bring me in the world didn't sound very exciting. We couldn't believe what happened. I agreed not to bug Dad so much about being a Scrooge so much, and not to call him a Scrooge so much. Once he stopped stealing money from me, I should develop the nerves to have the wound over his shoulder once in a while. I couldn't argue with that. Anyway, I'm having my birthday at Dave & Buster's. Anyway, Mom and Dad made me promise never to do vigilante justice again. My parents made me promise my puppet show days were over. Well, I figured it was always video and DVD. Maybe I'll come up with something fun other than the puppet shows. Anyway, John Paul went to live in Aminar, Florida. They went through by car. That's a crazy thing about John Paul. That's one thing I like about John Paul. Oh. Here he is, a millionaire who can easily jump aboard a jet plane. We went there by car and moving them. I'm not sure whether I'll see him again this year, but I know. And the station did deliver. And we'll see what happens this weekend. I'm not sure whether I'll be coming down here again next year. You know how it is. So is that person that determines whether you're naughty or nice. I'm not talking just Santa Claus. Anyway, Mom and Dad made me promise never to do puppet shows again. Well, I figured it's always video.
Neighborhood. And there's Mr. Applebaum's house. Jack was 5 when we moved in. Fee was only 3. It's been ages since I've been back to this neighborhood. You know, I have a really hard time picturing Jack as a little kid. Let's just say he was full of energy. I'm so sorry to hear that. When did Mr. Applebaum die?
A few months ago. He had a good long life. My uncle was so fond of you and his family, Molly. How much for this? $10?
There's a lot of cool stuff here.
Cool old stuff. My uncle didn't believe in throwing anything away. There you go.
So please, give our condolences to the rest of the family.
I will.